Morning, 4587. Beautiful day.
Lights out!
Oliver, it's been 5 months, man. Being out of control, I know, is not your strong suit.
Focusing on what I can control. Keep my head down. Avoid conflict.
Not fighting back. Never been who you were.
Star City continues to employ a zero-tolerance policy against any and all acts of vigilantism.
There have been no vigilantes in this city for 5 months.
As to the identity of this unknown assailant, this is someone new.
Oliver asked us to carry on.
Sometimes people just need something to believe in.
I have to fight back.
Oliver Queen took everything from me. I'm gonna enjoy taking everything from him.
Is that what I think it is?
Couldn't have been heroes for just a little bit longer.
Oh, relax, Sarah. We didn't screw things up for the better this time. We screwed things up for the more magical.
Hello, John.
Sarah, the darkness, it's rising. Malus wasn't the only prisoner to escape his realm when you decided to pull back the veil between our worlds. Throughout history, immortal monsters have returned to prey upon humanity. The only thing between life as we know and complete pandemonium is you bloody wankers.
The legends have things under control.
Show yourself, because I'm a nasty piece of work.
You will not escape.
The Bureau needs the legends now more than ever.
We're a team of outcasts and misfits. You're one of us. I'm confused. We are all happy that there was only one dragon, right?
Well, it would be good for our ratings. But don't worry, we have a few dedicated fans.
Hey everybody, happy Comic-Con week continues. That's right, it's not over. We got to talk about all this new DC footage, starting with Arrow. So they already explained a whole bunch of stuff and the new characters, the Longbow Hunters, all that stuff. So if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe to get all the DC videos. I'm doing a weekly Flash Ring giveaway too. All you have to do to enter that is be a subscriber and leave a comment on the video. I'll name a new winner at the end of this. The important stuff though, you probably noticed some pretty big Arrow villains inside Slab Side with Oliver. As of episode 1, he's been inside there for 5 months just giving it to people, like you see all the bruises all over his face. I'm sure it's been a lot of fun, but we see Brick, we see Bronze Tiger, who I don't think we've seen since season 2, and then Cody Rhodes' character at least. There are a bunch of other minor characters that I'm sure will pop up, but I think the idea is that Brick is sort of the organizer inside there. The other lesser villains are working for him. Just like the Kingpin was controlling people during Daredevil season 2 while the Punisher was in prison. Remember how they threw Punisher to the wolves? Imagine Brick doing a version of that with Oliver. They're doing Richard Dragon's Longbow Hunters like they teased at the end of last season. They confirmed Red Dart, Kodiak, and Silencer. The only one of those three that was a member of Richard Dragon's comic book version of the Longbow Hunters was Red Dart. But these are the three that the show is going to go with. Roy is back. They say that he's a different character than the last time we saw him. Remember, when he went off with Thea, they were going to try and destroy the remaining Lazarus pits. That's a bit of a Talia al Ghul plot. So Silencer, the Longbow Hunter, has a tie to Talia and the League of Assassins in the comics. They might bring Talia back this season. Now you see Richard Dragon chasing down William, wearing a green hoodie, just like Oliver was during season 4. That's a bit of a wink to maybe someday William putting on the hood. But the new showrunner confirmed that we would not be seeing William become a vigilante this season because he's just way too young. He's still very young. Maybe in a couple years if he gets a little bit older. For some reason, there were people at the panel that were asking if Oliver was going to have a baby with Felicity, and both the showrunner, Stephen Amell, and Emily Bett Ricards all said hard pass. No Oliver Felicity baby anytime soon. So hopefully that clears that up. It looks like it's going to be a pretty solid season. Reminder about the crossover, though. The Batwoman crossover is going to be episode 9 of all the episodes because Flash is going to have its 100th episode during episode 8. They wanted to do their own thing with that, so they special requested that they push the crossover to episode 9. Because the crossover will be the mid-season finale for everyone, they will have a teaser at the end of that that will push them into the second halves of all their seasons. But remember, it's all about introducing the Batwoman character within the universe so that she can do her spin-off TV show next year sometime. No idea when that would premiere. I'm assuming that it's going to be fall 2019 when everything comes back. No idea if this is going to be Arrow's last season. Stephen Amell said that the writers are swinging for the fence on the off chance that it is their last season, but there's a really complicated answer to whether or not it actually will be their last season. A lot of that has to do with the other new TV shows that the CW has coming in, how strong those are. Arrow doesn't have to be the highest rated TV show. It just has to be rated higher than most of the other TV shows that they do. So as long as it does pull better ratings than a lot of other CW programs, it should be fine. The season looks like it's going to be pretty solid, so I do think that ratings will go up quite a bit over last year. But moving on to Legends, big news on Legends is they've cast two new characters. They're not going to be part of the three-way crossover now because it's only going to be three of the TV shows. The new member of the team, because Wally West is leaving, the new member of the team is going to be called Alaska Yu. She's not a character from the comics. They're doing Citizen Steel's father. He's going to be played by Tom Wilson. And then the actress that plays Amaya is coming back, but she's going to be a different character. So just remember, this is Constantine's season. He's going to be leading the Wave Rider. It'll be them chasing down magical creatures like the unicorn that you see at Woodstock here in the trailer. Sam Witwer, the actor that played Doomsday on Smallville, is coming on Supergirl as one of the villains. His name's going to be Agent Liberty. I think you probably have a pretty good idea for the tone of the character and how they're going to use him. He's giving off a very Took Our Jobs South Park vibe, so that's basically what he's going to be doing, but in a giant suit wearing a mask. The Kryptonian suit that you see Supergirl wearing is actually probably a version of the comic book Eradicator armor. In double shocking twist, it's probably the Red Sun version of Kara that we saw at the end of last season. I think the reason they're doing this is from a practical standpoint. One, it kind of looks cool, but also so that when you have both versions of Supergirl in scenes at the same time, it's easier for them to not have to use CG and spend money on that. Remember how they handled Barry and Savitar? That's kind of what they're doing with Supergirl this season, except that the other version of Supergirl is the Red Sun Supergirl. So I almost forgot, if you watch Krypton, they're doing Lobo, Flamebird, and Nightwing on season 2. Those are the new characters they confirm. There's still so much Comic-Con stuff for me to get through. I will do a video about what's going to happen with Guardians of the Galaxy 3 next. But congratulations to the latest giveaway winner, Dynamo Effect. Please email me on the back end of my channel so I can get your contact details. Click here to rewatch the Flash season 5 trailer, and click here to rewatch the Shazam and Aquaman trailers. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.